10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the UKZN Wonder Women in Science webinar. My name is LIRA, and I'm so thrilled and so excited to be part of this wonderful initiative that celebrates women in science. Our hope today is that all of you will unleash your greatness through this webinar.
Hey, oh. I just wanna feel good every day. I wanna wear a smile upon my face. I wanna feel the joys of the day. I wanna feel alive in every moment. Said I won't waste time on feeling blue. I won't waste time on things I cannot change. I'm gonna live this day as best as I care. I'm doing everything that feels right, singing la 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 la. I wanna hear the laughter of a child. I wanna
so very much. Now do enjoy the webinar.
Oh wow, Miss LIRA, ladies and gentlemen, Miss LIRA! I've always wanted to say that, and tell me that each and every one of you, wherever you were right now, were just dancing along and singing la 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 la. La 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 la. What an incredible woman, what an incredible performer, and certainly bringing forth all of the feel good vibes. Thank you very much once again to Miss LIRA for introducing us to this day with that wonderful performance. And to you, all of you who are tuned in right now, a very big warm welcome to UKZN's Wonder Women in Science webinar. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Katlego Maboe, and it is indeed a pleasure and an honor to be your virtual MC today at this very, very special occasion where, as LIRA said, we are celebrating the most wonderful women in science and truly hoping that you will be inspired and feel that this urge to just unleash your greatness out there. Now, of course, the Wonder Women in Science campaign is run in the month of August, and this is done to commemorate National Science Week as well as Women's Month. And if you're wondering, who are these Wonder Women in Science? Well, as you see now, they are passionate, they are pioneering and persistent heroines who are making big waves in the world of science. And it's a campaign that's been run since 2015, and since then has honored some 30 female scientists from UKZN's College of Agriculture, Engineering and Science. Now, the WWIS campaign is industry recognized as an initiative, having won a second Marketing Advancement and Communication in Education, or MACE award, at the end of 2019. And this it did in competition against all higher education institutions in South Africa. Now, the WWIS also has been making quite a big splash in the media. I'm sure that you would have read about them in publications like the Sunday Tribune, in like Isolezwe, the Rising Sun, and the Daily News, just to name a few. And you would have also heard them on the airwaves on East Coast Radio, on SAFM, on Metro FM, and Radio KwaZulu as well. In fact, last week, SABC did a feature on Dr. Bongiwe, Mshengu, and the university and the WWIS campaign, which was broadcasted on SABC News, truly showing and signifying that these are all stories that we want to hear today that do resonate with all people all across the country and giving true validation to this wonderful initiative. Now, of course, normally we do host the WWIS breakfast as a massive event where we all get together, we meet, we share stories, we share in a meal. But COVID-19 has happened, not just to us here, but all across the world. So the university and the initiative, everything had to be changed around. We all had to adjust. So this morning, all that we ask is that you arrange the breakfast wherever you are, and we will ensure the entertainment and the inspiration comes your way in spades. Now, just before we get started officially with the proceedings of the morning, I want to just take you through a couple of housekeeping rules that will help you to view this webinar in the most optimal manner. Now, in the top right corner of your screen, you'll see two icons that will allow you to toggle between the speaker and the gallery view. Now, this is how they differ. The gallery view lets you see all the speakers all at once in a grid, whereas the speaker view will show you just the person who's speaking with the screen being shared as well. But I will guide you throughout the webinar and tell you exactly when to switch between the two of them. Now, only the panelists will be visible during the webinar. All of the attendees won't be visible, but of course, please do interact with us. This is a very interactive process, and we'd love for you to do that through our Q&A and polling features on this Zoom webinar. So whenever you have any kinds of questions, go ahead, ask them during that or in that Q&A feature, and one of our staff members will be on hand to answer them for you. And when we put up a poll, we would love your participation as well. It makes it fun and interactive. But do not use the chat feature though, because if we have 100, I mean, right now we've got about 298 people in this entire webinar. So imagine that chat room. It could be a lot of noise. It makes it a little bit more difficult for us to keep up with who's saying what. So the Q&A feature and the polling feature are what we are going to be using this morning. So it's time for us right now to introduce our panelists and to say hello to them. And so please, to everyone, please switch over to gallery view right now. And as you do so, I'm going to introduce our panelists. And panelists, as I introduce you, please turn on your audio, turn on your video, and give us a big smile and a hello. So first up, let's say hello to Dr. Lorika Biekus. Good morning, Dr. Biekus.
Hi, everyone. Hi, Katlego.
Are you very well this morning?
I'm very well, thank you.
Fantastic. Great to have you with us. Looking forward to hearing from you later on. Next up, let's say hello to Dr. Joy Adu. Good morning, Dr. Adu.
Good morning, everyone.
And how are you feeling this morning? Very excited, I'm sure.
Very excited. Very well, thank you.
Excellent. Great to have you with us. Next up, hello, Professor Suna Kassier. Good morning to you.
Good morning, everybody. Lovely to be with you. Can't wait to share my story.
Absolutely fantastic. Thanks for joining us. Let's say hello to Dr. Bongiwe Mshengu. A very good morning, Dr. Mshengu.
Good morning, everyone. I'm fantastic. It's very great to be here.
Fantastic. Great to have you too. Followed up by Dr. Hlonipile Sithole Mthethwa. A very good morning to you.
Good morning. I'm so excited.
Looking very busy in the office there with all those meeting schedules behind you. Hey, got lots to do, but thank you very much for taking time out of your busy schedule to join us. And last but certainly not least, Dr. Tanya Reinhardt. A very good morning to you, Dr. Reinhardt. Dr. Reinhardt, just switch on your audio this, audio so we can hear the sound as well. There we go.
Okay, good morning, everybody, from a sunny and beautiful Cape Town, and I'll see you later.
Fantastic. And I hear that you go by another name as well as a Dr. T. The waves of the rumor mill has been abound. Dr. T is the new cool Dr. T in the house. But thank you very much once again to all of our panelists. We do look forward to hearing all of your inspiring stories a little bit later on. I see everyone has, of course, switched off their cameras and their audio, which means that we can proceed. Now, we are also broadcasting this morning from two high schools who are part of UKZN's feeder schools, and these are Umkhumbani Secondary School all the way in Chesterville, as well as Ikusasalenja Secondary School in Inanda. Now, just so you know, we have adhered to very strict level 2 lockdown protocols and regulations, in the sense that not more than 50 people are gathered at the venue itself, and everyone is wearing a mask, has been sanitized, and of course, they are socially distancing from one another. And of course, we'd like to say a very good morning to them, see what the excitement is like at those two schools. So first up, let's quickly say hello to everyone at Umkhumbani Secondary. Please put on your video and your audio. Give us a big wave and say hello. There we go, very good. Good to see you guys, looking very, very slick and cool in your uniform. Wow, I wish my school's uniform looked like that back in the day, but that's everyone joining us at Umkhumbani. Great to see you guys. And I would also like to say a big hello to everyone at Ikusasalenja Secondary School. Please put on your video and audio. Give us a big wave and say hello. There they are, bringing the energy, bringing the good vibes. I hope that you guys are all excited. If you're all excited about what's happening today, scream! I love it. It's good to hear from all of the schools. But for now, please put your audio off and do keep your video on. And as you do that, I'd like to just take a moment to say a big thank you to Amazon Web Services for donating the bags, and notebooks, and the pens for all of the students at Umkhumbani and Ikusasalenja. Now, we also have Eden College, who are joining us this morning on the webinar. Now, they attend the WWIS breakfast event every year, but this year they decided to throw their own tea party in their science lab and watch the webinar as a group. So let's say hello to them. Eden College, please put your video and audio on and give us a big hello. Let's hear you again say hello. Well, I'm sure that they can hear. There we go. That's much better. I like to hear nice big voices in the morning. Great to have you guys here with us as well. But for now, you can put your audio and your video off. We'd also like to take a moment to just thank all of our corporate relations division of UKZN for donating water bottles, they donated bags and highlighters to all of the students at Eden College. Thank you very, very much. I'd also like to take a moment as we begin to acknowledge the following schools who are also broadcasting the webinar in their classrooms, but not on camera. And we'd like to say a big hello to Nomavimbela High, to Usetubeni Youth School, Dr. A.D. Lazarus Secondary, and Solvista Secondary. We are so happy that you can join us, and we hope that you too do find inspiration in this wonderful celebration this morning. But for now, all of our attendees, please switch back to speaker view, because we are ready to start things off with an official word of welcome from the formidable Deputy Vice Chancellor and Head of the College of Agriculture, Engineering and Science, Professor Albert Modi. Now, Professor Modi was employed by the then University of Natal in 1996 and has been associated with UKZN since. He helped establish the Ezemvelo Farmers Organization, a sustainable agriculture organization of farmers who produce organic taro in KZN. Professor Modi's research interest is in the broad area of agronomy, including crop science and seed science, plant physiology, field crop management, underutilized and neglected crops, and sustainable agriculture. Now, we're going to watch a recorded message from Professor Modi, where he will deliver his official word of welcome and open the event for us officially. So, roll that clip.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Albert Modi, the Deputy Vice Chancellor for the College of Agriculture, Engineering and Science at the University of KwaZulu-Natal. Do you remember 1956? That year, in August, 2,000 women stood up and they spoke out. And there were many, many results as a result of their speaking out. The major one is that South Africa in 1994 decided to have a women's charter for equality. Today, the major one is science and education. Today, the University of KwaZulu-Natal celebrates science, technology, and engineering on behalf of women who succeed in these endeavors and these disciplines. This is happening in a country that has got a history of inequality, not only on the basis of race, but also on the basis of gender. Now, everyone is equal. All women are equal, regardless of the background where they come from. As the University of KwaZulu-Natal, we are proud of the support that we've been given by the government of South Africa and the people who fund our teaching and research at the University of KwaZulu-Natal. We celebrate the success of this university in attracting women from the deep rural areas, the townships and other urban areas to study at the University of KwaZulu-Natal. At the University of KwaZulu-Natal, we have all the facilities that you need to study science, engineering, mathematics, economics, and every other related discipline. At the University of KwaZulu-Natal, we have A-rated scientists who are recognized by the world and this nation. The University of KwaZulu-Natal is in the top 500 universities of the world, the top 5 universities of South Africa. That is why we are able to take a woman who went to a school that was ranked very lowly to a university that is ranked very highly and make them succeed as a scientist. We select 5 wonderful women every year, and these are Dr. Joy Adu, an engineer, Dr. Lorica Bukes, a biologist, Dr. Fonipile Mtetwa, a mathematician, Dr. Suna Kassier, a dietitian, and Dr. Bongiwe, Mshengu, a chemist. These are the women that we are proud of as a university and would like you as a nation to join us in celebrating their success. These are the women who will carry the flag of UKZN and the flag of South Africa into the future. These are the women who will be part of the solutions for this country and the world as we face many challenges, including climate change and the COVID-19 virus. These are the women who are part of the world scientists to find a solution to these problems. These are the shining stars of the University of KwaZulu-Natal in 2020. They will continue to be shining into the future. We are very proud of them. I would like to thank everybody who has joined the University of KwaZulu-Natal in this endeavor to make South Africa a better place. Thank you very much. Watinta bafazi, watinti mbokodo.
My word, what an incredible word of welcome there from Professor Modi. Thank you very much. And as you think about the history and the significance of this month and what we are celebrating today, you see these wonder women in science as stepping into that greatness, as continuing that legacy, as continuing to inspire us as a nation. Thank you very, very much once again for those wonderful words, Professor Modi. Watinta bafazi, watinti mpokoto. Well, right now, I hope that you have adjusted your screens appropriately to speak of you, because it is time for us right now to hear from our speakers. And I am very, Very excited to hear about each of their stories. And our first WWIS candidate is Dr. Bongiwe Mshengu from the School of Chemistry and Physics. Now, Dr. Mshengu is senior tutor in UKZN's Science Access Program and dreams of a day when she will see an African child relating to the science underpinning everyday life. Now, let's watch a short introduction video and then we will hear from Dr. Mshengu.
Hi, I'm Bongiwe Mshengu. I'm a chemist and a Wonder Woman in science. Discover my story on our website.
Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Bongiwe Mshengu, a lecturer in the Science Access Program and a researcher in the School of Physics and Chemistry. So I was interested in medicine from a very young age. And this is because I had experience or I was exposed to the healing powers of medicinal plants. So in my young age, at an age of 6 years old, I had a wound on my feet, which was treated by herbs from a traditional healer. So from this day, I appreciated the healing powers of plants, but I also wondered how plants were able to heal various diseases. Now, when I moved to high school, I chose science subjects because I wanted to be a medical doctor and heal people. But I also chose science subjects because I was a hard worker and the teachers and my family recommended that I do this subject. Then my dream of being a doctor was shattered when I did not meet all the requirements for this degree. Instead, I was accepted for a Bachelor of Sciences degree at UKZN. And this was a Bachelor of Science in Dietetics. Now, I knew nothing about this degree. All I knew is that there's something called dietetics because my teacher recommended that I can do it. Then I had to use my first year to research about the various science careers that you can do at this university. I then was interested in the Bachelor of Sciences, majoring in chemistry and biochemistry. Now, this is because I heard that in this degree, you can study drug discovery and development, in particular from medicinal plants. I then obtained my BSc degree and honors degree majoring in chemistry, my master's in organic chemistry, as well as PhD in natural product chemistry. Now, when I first enrolled at the university, my dream was to get a first degree and go and get a job. However, I realized in my second year of study that actually you can study further and do postgraduate studies. And at that time, I was told there's something called a PhD. Now, this was interesting to me because I was told that when you do this, then you'll be involved in various research projects. You can develop these projects yourself. And already in my head, I had some projects that I was interested in from childhood. For instance, I knew what plants were using back home to treat various diseases. Now, this was a chance for me to find out what are the chemicals in these plants. Then my journey has also had some challenges. For instance, at some point, this was back in high school, I also thought that science was difficult and boring. And this was partly due to the fact that in our school, we had minimal exposure into the laboratory. And so I could not relate well what was taught in theory and what was being done in the lab. So this made my performance in these subjects to be very poor. So then my perception changed when I joined UKZN. This is when I saw that actually science subjects, they have both the theoretical and practical component, and this enhanced my understanding in these subjects. And in my first year, I was very lucky to be taught by some of the very passionate lecturers. For instance, I'll give a shout out to Dr. Murray Law, who taught me chemistry and used everyday examples to do this. And Professor Davis, who taught me physics and used live demonstrations in class. And this made me realize that science is interesting, science is relevant, and science is part of our everyday lives. My other challenge is from high school, I had very poor career guidance, as I said. I only knew that you can be a medical doctor or an engineer. And I was told at school that engineering is for boys. So then I was just left with medicine. Now, this all changed when I joined UKZN again, and this is when I learned that there are so many science careers, and you can enroll in any one of them and excel regardless of your background. Another challenge I've had in my field is there are few role models or few women in the field, so that few role models, few mentors, and few collaborators for young female scientists. However, I've been lucky to work with some of the wonderful women in this field. I can mention two of them. One is my PhD supervisor, Professor Fanny van Nierden, who taught me how to be a resilient researcher. And then the second one is Dr. Roshila Moodley, who is my mentor and my collaborator. And she's teaching me the ropes of how to supervise research students. And I'm very grateful to these ladies. Another challenge I've had in my field, I feel this one is a general challenge for most working mothers out there, is the fact that we have to be at work and we have additional duties at home. So with this, we need to find a balance between work and home duties. So I have used some strategies to cope with this. For instance, I set some achievable goals for myself. I focus. I do not compete with other people. I make sure that my family understands my situation. Now, another thing that I've done for myself is to attend some inspirational talks from other women scientists in the field. For instance, every year I attend the Wonder Women in Science, listen to their stories. And I also go to the Imbogoto Women seminars, which are organized by Human Resources at UKZN. And I feel these stories are very helpful because then they tell us that there are women in this field and these women are successful. And then we take notes from them. Now, why do I think young people out there should be scientists? First of all, science is interesting. Science is fun, and science should be done by most people in the world. As a developing country, South Africa needs more scientists because we need to improve our economy. We need to do this by adapting and developing our own technologies, and you can only do this if we have scientists. Also, we need to have well-skilled people out there, and the only way we can do this is to train people to be scientists. Or the other thing that we need is we need to be able to create job opportunities, and this can be achieved as well through science. Now, the country also needs more women scientists because women have got unique personalities that they can bring to this field. For instance, women are naturals, women are organized, and women are resilient. All these traits are very important in the science field, and they can help to attract other women in this field. Now, I will tell you from my experience in the field of science that science is for people who enjoy problem solving. It is for people who like hands-on experiments to prove theoretical concepts. It is for curious people. It is for organized people. Science does not discriminate based on your gender, on your color, or on your educational background. If you're still in high school, you need to find out about the different science careers. You need to identify if you're interested in any one of them, and then you need to work hard to obtain those grades. If you do not obtain those marks, of course, you do not lose hope because your life is waiting for you out there. You need to upgrade those marks. You need to apply for alternative entryways into the university. For instance, in the College of Agriculture, Engineering and Science at UKZN, we've got Science Access Program, and we've got Engineering Access Program for as an entryway to those degrees. More importantly, I do think that you do not need to study for the sake of studying. You need to make sure that you've identified your passion, because you do not want to be stuck in a job that you hate for 30 years or more. Also, finally, if you consistently work hard, of course, you're going to reap the rewards. And I hope that you guys are going to find that passion as a science career. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Bongiwe Mshengu. A privilege to have heard your story, an absolute honor to be inspired by it. You mentioned such beautiful anecdotes from your own life story And it really is inspiring. You talk about science's contribution to our economy, and I think it's so, so important that young people realize how they can contribute to the growth of our economy by investing in the knowledge of science. And you were talking also about, not competing with other people and truly trying to find the best within yourself. So thank you very much for that. Dr. Bongiwe Mshengu, you are still with us, I believe. I can still see you there. I wanted to ask, with your background in dietetics, I did hear you say that you've got a bit of a background in that, right?
Yes.
I need
just
to ask
one
you this,
year. Just 1 year.
I think it's sufficient. I need to ask you this question because I've been struggling with it for a long time. Do carrots actually make you see better?
I think Professor Suna is the right candidate to answer the question just after me. She's going to help you with that.
Well, we'll certainly touch on that. But before we say goodbye to you, could you please show us your award and your gift? There we go. And as Professor Mshengu or Dr. Mshengu does that, we want to thank Amazon Web Services for sponsoring an Kindle e-reader and Umgeni Water for sponsoring a fitness tracker and USB laser pointer pen for each of our Wonder Women in Science. Once again, a big thank you to you, Dr. Mshengu. Anything else that you'd like to add?
I would like to thank our College of Agriculture, Engineering and Science for the recognition as a Wonder Women candidate in 2020. This has been an exciting journey for me to share my story with South Africa. It has been great. Also, I'd like to thank our sponsors, the Amazon and Umgeni Water for the wonderful gifts. Thank you.
Absolutely wonderful. All right. Thank you very much. You may now switch your video and audio off. And to everyone that's watching, I hope that you found that story equally inspiring. I was enthralled by Dr. Bongiwe Mshengu's story over there. As we now move on to our next WWIS candidate, who's Professor Suna Kassier. Now, she's from the School of Agriculture, Earth and Environmental Sciences. Professor Kassier is the academic leader of teaching and learning for the school and associate professor of dietetics and human nutrition. She's an expert in the field of public health, where she focuses on infant and young child nutrition, obesity, body image, and food security. Now we're going to take a quick look at an introductory video, and then we'll hear from Professor Kassier.
Hello, I'm Suna Kassier. I'm a registered dietitian and a Wonder Woman in Science. Visit our website to learn more about my story.
Thank you very, very much. First of all, the reason why I chose We Will Rock You as my theme song is because I feel that science can really rock the world and make it a better place for everybody. So to start off with my story, I just want to first of all say, yes, I'm a registered dietitian, but if you look at my journey where I traveled to become where the person I am today, I just want to first of all share with you that if I look at my school career, I was not especially special or very talented in subjects like maths, for instance. I took home economics, which in my particular school was considered a subject that is very often taken by girls and girls that are not very bright. Having said that, I also took subjects like biology, where my teacher was very, very inspirational and made me realize, after all, science is a field to pursue and it can take you places. So that's just to give you a bit of an idea of my school career. So having said that, I took home economics. Food has always been my passion. We eat every single day. And I don't think people realize the influence that food has on both well-being and just also the plea of so many people in our own country, as well as across the planet, that actually don't have enough food to eat, which of course is not only tragic, but it is something that we should all aspire to improve. So when I started my university career, I, to my horror, had to enroll in subjects like maths. And as I already shared with you, I was not particularly gifted at maths at school. But then I came across or had the pleasure of having a maths lecturer that was quite inspirational. And it made me then realize, you know, after all, I'm maybe not as shabby in maths as I thought. So that was something that really boosted my ego or my self-esteem. And of course, then subjects that I learned to really, really enjoy at university level were physiology and biochemistry. So what then followed is I did my honors. And when I enrolled for my honors, I actually enrolled for a course in statistics, which I already passed as an undergrad, but I still felt, you know, maybe I'm not on top of it. So what I'm trying to also share here is that you must actually, if you have a demon, or if you have an area where you feel maybe you're not as accomplished as you feel you should be, never give up. And you always should be competing against yourself and nobody else. So I actually worked in numerous areas of my profession. And I then realized that, you know, my true passion lies within tertiary education and being passionate about the students. And I've been in tertiary education now for over 2 decades. And my greatest level of job satisfaction comes from inspiring and hopefully serving as a role model for, sorry, I've got a frog in my throat, for other young scientists. And I must definitely say that if I look at staff at our university, they are passionate about what they do. And it's astounding to see the lengths that some staff go to actually assist their students in achieving to be the best that they can be. So my master's as well as my PhD is something that I pursued in a part-time capacity while working full-time at two different universities. And I also learned the importance of juggling time and also realizing that, you know, at the end of the day, as a woman, you are not only an academic trying to better yourself through your studies, but you also have to fulfill the role of a mother as well as a wife. So that was a difficult time in my life because it meant that, you know, I had to very often work while others may be asleep. And this is also a message that I actually just want to give all potential university students as a message, is that for you to actually pursue your dreams, it sometimes means that you actually have to be awake while others are sleeping, in the sense that you've got to work hard. Science is a very, very exciting field, but it is an area that requires dedication, commitment, but I can assure you that the rewards you will reap are actually just phenomenal. And as I already said, with science, we're trying to make the world a better place. So I just also thought that I would like to share just a few pearls of wisdom this morning. What I've learned, not only as a scientist, but also helping young people every day to actually make their dreams come true. So for me, it's all a matter of opportunity knocking very softly. And there are opportunities out there. And it's just a matter of actually grabbing those opportunities. And I think you will hear some other examples from my fellow nominees. So that is something that I feel very passionate about. Find a role model for yourself, whether it be a teacher, a member of your family. For instance, my love of reading was actually inspired by a family member, in fact, my aunt. And that also made me realize that, you know, in the area of science, the world is ever changing. And it's important as a scientist to become a lifelong learner. because as we make new discoveries, we've actually got to stay on top of, for instance, what the latest trends and areas of importance are within our society, because as scientists, we are trying to solve those problems that society are experiencing. For me, it's also very important to actually maintain a sense of humor and to laugh, because sometimes the world might seem very difficult. You might find that your circumstances are very difficult, but finding just the lighter side of life, or actually seeking it out actively, is also something that can really make a difference. And if you observe people around you that are not feeling on top of the world, maybe they're struggling at school, or maybe their home circumstances are not that wonderful, just make sure to give them a smile, because a smile is really something that can make a huge difference to the lives of people around you. And then when you are facing obstacles in every aspect of your life, just remember that tomorrow is another day, and grab every day with the opportunities that that day holds when you wake up in the morning. And then I also just want to echo my fellow colleague who just also mentioned the fact that you should never compare yourself to others, but compare yourself to yourself in terms of the goals that you want to achieve. Because at the end of the day, you are the author of your success story. So just always remember that. And that realize that for you to be the best that you can be, you need to become a lifelong learner, an ever-changing world. That the world changes overnight. So just be aware of that. And we can only accomplish if we make sure that we are adaptable, and also if we try to be humble with everything that we do and achieve. And then the last thing I just wanted to say is that science is and always will be making the world a better place for not only those around us, but for people globally. So from that perspective, I think pursuing a career in science is the best gift you can give yourself as well as to society. Thank you.
Well, absolutely wonderful. Thank you very much, Professor Kassier. I think just from what you've just said, it's so important for us to realize, and because we face challenges every single day in differing magnitudes and in all aspects of our life. But just like you said, to remember that tomorrow is another day. The sun will rise again, and there will be an opportunity for us to try better, to do better. So thank you very much for sharing those words of inspiration. And maybe you can answer my question that I was asking earlier on to Dr. Mshengu about carrots. Do they actually make you see better?
Well, carrots will make you see better if you have a vitamin A deficiency. And if you are not vitamin A deficient, let me tell you, carrots have actually got other benefits. So carrots are not only meant for rabbits. Carrots contain a lot of other important components that, for instance, they contain dietary fiber, which helps to keep you regular. And I think we should leave it at that. But we need to be aware that South Africa has got a public health problem related to a vitamin A deficiency. And therefore, if you, for instance, look at foods like maize and bread, you'll see that they are fortified with vitamin A. So apart from, you know, being aware of that, carrots is important, yes.
And I guess this is where I learned my lesson that next time you ask a scientist a question, don't just expect a yes or no. It is going to be a comprehensive answer. Professor Kassier, would you mind showing us your wonderful gift as well that you have received? There we go. Fantastic. And yes, as you do so, we also want to thank Amazon Web Services for donating and sponsoring a Kindle e-reader, and Umgeni Water for sponsoring a fitness tracker and USB laser pointer pin for each of our Wonder Women in Science. Professor Kassier, anything else that you'd like to add, please?
Yes, well, apart from the fact that I'm extremely grateful to the College of Agriculture, Engineering and Science to be part of this really worthy campaign, I also just want to thank the sponsors. And I also want to say I'm very grateful for having been, receiving this honor. But at the same time, I actually deliberately did not choose to show my award this morning or my recognition to be part of this campaign, because I just want to also tell all the young people out there is that you don't necessarily have to be a winner to be the best. Do what you do best and just take it from there. Thank you so much. Over to you.
Well said, Professor Kassier. Thank you very, very much for those inspirational words, for sharing your story with us. That certainly will sit in our minds for quite some time, and I'm sure inspire all of the young people watching. You may switch off your video and your audio as well. Well, I hope that you are enjoying this so far, everyone who's tuned in. Of course, do remember to use that Q&A feature on this webinar in order to ask all of your questions. And of course, we'll have some polls coming up a bit later on as well. And when they do pop up on your screen, please do engage with us as we now move on to our next speaker, Dr. Joy Adu, who is a lecturer in civil engineering at UKZN and an expert in water quality modeling and wastewater engineering. Now, she dreams of changing the way water is used and preserved for present and future generations. She has been chosen this year as one of our Wonder Women in Science as a candidate from the School of Engineering, and we'll learn more about her from her story. But first, here's a short little introductory video.
Hi, I'm Dr. Joy Adu, a civil engineer and a Wonder Woman in Science. Visit our website to learn more about my story.
Hello everyone, it's good to be here. I'm really excited to share my story with you. My journey started quite a number of years ago. While I was growing up, two things stood against me. I had those obstacles, one coming from a humble background and the second being a female child. Then it was assumed that the place of a woman is in the kitchen eventually. So there was actually no need for the girl child to have a formal education. Well, I got into my school, secondary school, but the ladies, the girls in the school were very much like Prof. Suna. We were all assigned to the home economics club, and all the boys were assigned to the science and maths club. After a while, I got so inquisitive and I wanted to know that why were we all in the home economics class? I would sneak out of the home economics club and go and see what's happening in the boys' club. And I wondered why we weren't there, because I thought we were doing much more in the home economics club, because we were measuring out ingredients to cook. And I saw that something was happening in the cooking pot, some form of reaction. And I felt we were applying mathematics more than the boys in the mathematics club. So I walked up to the teacher and I asked, why can't I be here with the boys? They all laughed at me, but I was resolute and I said I wanted to be there. I had so much against the fact that I couldn't be there because I was a girl. And so they allowed me to stay there. And I wasn't that good at maths at that point, but because I knew I had to prove that I deserved to be there, I applied myself to study. And then I started doing so well in mathematics, far and over and above the boys. But how did I start my journey into becoming a civil engineer? Then you could either become a nurse as a female or something else, but definitely not an engineer. Being an engineer was a man's job. But very close to where I lived, there was a construction site and I would watch the men there. So I asked, what is this? And they said, this is part of civil engineering. I went back and I studied and I found out that civil engineering was such a fantastic profession. And there were so many aspects of civil engineering, you know? I looked at the roads, I looked at water supply, and I realized that these were all by civil engineers. And so I decided that no matter what, I was going to become a civil engineer. The journey started, first of all, with my getting a bachelor's of engineering in civil. And then from then on, I felt there was no letting up. I wanted to know more. So I registered for a master's in structures, which I completed. And after finishing that program in structures, I also thought, no, I wanted to know more about water because I saw the environment that wasn't clean water coming out of the pipes and, you know. So I went on and I had another master's. I registered for another master's in water resources and environmental engineering. But at that time, while at school for my first degree, we were just two girls in the class with more than, you know, 90 boys in the class. So it was very, very challenging. It was tough. It was difficult to keep our heads above. And it was also difficult because I really didn't have much support coming from home, apart from two amazing women in my life, my grandma and my mother, who actually believed that I could become whoever I wanted to. We didn't have finances. For those of us who might feel, oh, it might have been easy, we didn't have the finances. My mom and my grandma had to scrape up whatever they could for me to get to the university. And I had to fight with the boys to get a scholarship for my studies. And from then on, I felt, what's happening? We need more women. Civil engineering is an amazing, amazing course. And it needs people who apply details to their jobs. Because one mistake, one error by a civil engineer could cost the lives of millions. A doctor could make a mistake, but it could be just one person that is affected. A civil engineer makes a mistake with a structure, you can imagine the number of people that go down. A bridge collapses, you can imagine the number of people that go down with it. If the water that comes from the waterworks is polluted, you can imagine the number of people that go down with it. So I felt that the best thing for me to do was to go into the career of mentoring other young women to take up this profession that is very detailed, that pays attention to details, because women by nature pay attention to details. Was it easy? No, not by any means. And after my second master's in water resources and environmental engineering, I registered for a PhD in civil engineering at UKZN, where I currently lecture. Ladies, all of you watching right now, nobody has the right to determine who you become. There is nothing that says you cannot achieve your dreams. Look at me now. No one ever gave me a chance in a million to sit here before you as a civil engineer. So, no one can determine who you are because you're a female. No one can determine who you become because of your background. Your background might be bad, but make sure that you don't let your back touch the ground. Stay focused. Was it easy? No. Is it going to be challenging for you? Yes. But can it be done? Yes. You can achieve that dream. So go on, make up your mind. You have to study. You have to burn the midnight oil. You have to be focused. you must ensure that you do not have distractions that would cause you to lose focus. No one has the right to define who you become but you. So, with my final words today, ladies, women, we are powerful. We are strong. We are goal-getters. We are people who can become and do whatever in spite of our upbringing, our background, our cultural leanings. Just keep going, keep focusing. And if perchance you choose to join in with the profession of civil engineering, by all means, you're welcome to the Department of Civil Engineering, University of KwaZulu-Natal. It is a place of first choice for you because we have awesome women there also who will mentor you and make sure you achieve your dreams. We have awesome men as well, but we're focusing on women. We have awesome, awesome mentors. Thank you for giving me this privilege to share my experience and my journey with you. Thank you so much. Over to you, Katlego.
Oh, wow. And Dr. Adu, what a joy you are to listen to, and fascinating, inspirational in the very sense of the word. I was actually wondering while listening to you, telling us about your story, about the field of civil engineering and some of the great minds out there that have built great structures. I was privileged enough to visit Dubai last year and got to see the Burj Khalifa, that I think one of the tallest skyscrapers in the world, a magnificent structure indeed. And I was wondering, what is one of your favorite structures in the world from a civil engineering point of view?
I would say the Eiffel Tower in Paris. Yeah.
It is a beautiful thing, and the city of love as well. But thank you very much. Inspirational story. We really do appreciate that. And if you wouldn't mind also please showing us your award and your gift, please.
Well, that is my award. Thank you, College of Greek and Engineering and Science. And that is my gift. Thank you to Mgeni Water and Amazon.
Absolutely. You took the words right out of my mouth. Thanks for doing my hosting job for me. And before we let you go, Dr. Adu, is there anything else that you'd like to add?
I would honestly want to say I'm really humbled to have been chosen as the Wonder Woman in Science representative for the School of Engineering. Like I said, we have awesome women in School of Engineering. And so it's been a privilege, and I want to say thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you
so much. Happy Women's Month, everyone.
Happy Women's Month. Thank you very much, Dr. Adu. You may switch off your video and your audio for the moment. And just as a side note to all of our attendees, if you are experiencing a little bit of a lag, it might just be because of the connection that you have. So maybe if you switch over to a cabled connection, that might give you a bit of a stronger connection so that you can view the videos more in sync. But now over to our next candidate. We're talking about Dr. Lorica Biakas, and she's a principal microscopy technician at UKZN's microscopy and microanalysis unit, MMU. Now, as a microscopist and microbiologist, Dr. Biakas is fascinated by the major impact of the microbial world that it has on everyday life. And she's a WWIS candidate from the School of Life Sciences. Once again, we're going to watch a little introductory video, and then we'll hear from Dr. Biakas.
Hi, my name is Lorica Biakas, and I'm a microscopist and a microbiologist and a Wonder Woman in Science. And you can find out more about my story on our website.
Hi, everyone. My name is Lorica Biakas, and I'm a microscopist, microbiologist, and a Wonder Woman in Science. Today, my message is directed to the school child and the student aspiring to be a scientist one day. My scientific journey began as a child when I developed a keen interest in nature, from plants to animals and all the creepy crawlies in between. When I reached high school, I knew I wanted to be a scientist, doctor, or any other professional in the medical field. Although I had an idea of my dream career and I knew I had to study hard to achieve my goal, I underestimated the amount of work it would take to achieve my goal. I also knew that coming from a previously disadvantaged background, I would have to work when I finished school to help out at home and to support my needs. Eventually, with some motivation from my family, I pursued my tertiary studies in the sciences while also working on a part-time basis. I began my university career through the Science Access Program, which was an awesome experience and helped me to bridge the gap between school and university. I eventually completed my undergraduate degree in biomolecular technology and finally achieved my goal by completing my postgraduate studies, Bachelor of Science Honours, Master of Science, and PhD in microbiology. For my PhD research, I analyzed pit latrine feces for antibiotic-resistant bacteria and determined the level of contamination on household surfaces and municipal workers before and after pit latrine emptying. Microbiologists are scientists who study the growth, interactions, and characteristics of microscopic organisms like bacteria, algae, fungi, and protozoa. In my current role as a microscopist at the University of KwaZulu-Natal, I assist students, researchers, and commercial clients with the analysis of their research samples using highly specialized instruments called electron microscopes. Electron microscopes are very powerful instruments which have a much higher resolving power than light microscopes and can reveal the structure of very tiny objects in the nanometer range. My journey to becoming a scientist was not an easy one, as I had to balance the pressures of studying and also the pressures of work, as I had to do the two simultaneously in order to support my needs. However, the experience was amazing, and I wouldn't trade it for anything in this world. You too can be a scientist or anything you choose to be, irrespective of your age, your gender, race, and your background. All you need is focus, hard work, and determination. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Beerkis. Wonderful to hear your story and to be inspired by it as well. I can see some of the learners in the schools clapping and applauding your story as well. And as I was looking at your picture over here of you looking down one of those very powerful microscopes into the very many organisms that you see each and every day, I was wondering to myself, what is the most interesting organism you've ever seen through the lens of a microscope?
Such a tough question, Katlego. I've seen so many things, but I think the most interesting are insects, especially bees, their eyes. And to us, their eyes seem quite simple, just like a normal eyeball. But there's, when you look at it under the scanning electron microscope, it looks like they have a whole lot of tiny eyeballs all in one. So I think insects for now are the most fascinating.
Ah, absolutely wonderful. All right. I'd like you to please show us your award and your gift as well, please. There we have it. There we see it. Wonderful. So thank you very much to Amazon Web Services for sponsoring a Kindle e-reader and Umgeni Water for sponsoring a fitness tracker and USB laser pointer pen for each of our Wonder Women in Science. And before we let you go, Dr. Beerkis, what are some final thoughts that you'd like to share with us?
I'd also like to thank Amazon and Mshengu Water for the wonderful gifts. And I'd like to thank everyone who supported me throughout my career, especially my supervisor, Prof. Stefan Schmidt, my school teachers, my family, especially my parents and my two sisters and my niece, my friends, especially Rendani, and my colleagues, especially in Dombozuko Matyumza. I would also like to thank Sashlin and the PR team for putting together this wonderful event. And I'd like to wish all the women in South Africa a happy Women's Month.
And a happy Women's Month to you too, Dr. Beerkis. Thank you very much for your audio and your video. All right, this brings us now to our next inspirational story, which comes from none other than Dr. Hlonipile Sithole-Mthethwa, who is a lecturer who believes that mathematics is a language that we use daily and can become fluent in. She aims to become a mentor and professor, nurturing students who will produce meaningful research and achieve exponentially more than she has. She is our WWIS candidate from the School of Mathematics, Statistics and Computer Science. Let's watch a short little introduction video and we'll hear a story thereafter.
Hi, I'm Dr. Hlonipile Sithole-Mthethwa. I am a mathematician and a Wonder Woman in science. Visit our website to learn more about my story.
Good morning, everyone. Happy Women Month to all the girls and women of South Africa. My name is Hlonipile Sithole-Mthethwa. I'm a mathematician and a 2020 Wonder Woman in Science candidate. I recently graduated with PhD in Applied Mathematics. I had a lockdown graduation. I was born in Pietermaritzburg in KwaZulu-Natal and was raised by both my parents. I'm married to Buzani Mthethwa and blessed with two beautiful kids. My story about mathematics is, I think mathematics loved me first. As a young girl, I could do most math problems without any struggle and received math awards. At school, I would challenge myself by solving problems from grades ahead of mine. At that point, I definitely knew that I wanted to do more mathematics, but I was not really sure what exactly to do with that mathematics. Many young girls in various parts of the country are good in certain science subjects, but without proper guidance and availability of resources and information, they might end up not partaking in any STEM or science careers. That is why we need to intervene with such information. About my career path, I started off my career by getting Bachelor of Science in Applied Mathematics and Statistics from the University of KwaZulu-Natal, which has a strong mathematics department. Then I did BSc Honours in Biomathematics from Stellenbosch University in Western Cape. Thereafter, I obtained both the Masters of Science and PhD in Applied Mathematics from UKZN. So if you want to do any of these degrees, you can enroll with UKZN. My research interests are numerical methods and modeling in fluid dynamics and mathematical biology, including disease modeling. My PhD research was an intensive theoretical study in fluid dynamics with focus in heat and mass transfer. The particular application was on complex non-Newtonian nanofluid models in various geometries and boundary conditions, leading to highly nonlinear and coupled differential equations that I had to solve. Luckily for me, I had a good support structure from my husband and family. I am thankful to my supervisors, Prof. Sibanda and Prof. Mota, for their mentorship and vast knowledge, which encouraged me to widen my research from various perspectives. I am currently a mathematics lecturer in the School of Mathematics, Statistics and Computer Science at UKZN. I like to tell this story because I appreciate the UKZN's input in shaping my career. My first job in academia was teaching foundation math at Center for Science Access at UKZN. Thereafter, I was employed as a developmental lecturer through an accelerated academic development program known as AADP at UKZN. This particular program is aimed at young, aspiring academics with limited experience in academia, but with potential and interest to pursue a career in academia. Candidates are expected to register and complete a doctoral degree and are provided with training in supervision, academic writing, thesis writing, and so forth. I have since been credentialed and appointed as a full lecturer. I really love my job and enjoy working with students. They call me Dr. H. I wish to focus more on research and follow the specialization pathway. I want to be a professor one day and mentor students who will produce meaningful research and achieve multiple more times than myself. To me, mathematics indeed is an everyday universal science language. With enough practice, you end up being fluent in it. It occurs in nature and everyone uses it daily with or without realizing. I think every young person should consider taking a mathematics as a school subject, regardless of what career path they will eventually venture into. Most degrees require that students do take some form of maths, numeracy, or statistics modules. For instance, there is mathematics for natural sciences, quantitative methods for commerce, applied mathematics and calculus for engineering students, and so forth. So everyone is still expected to be able to interpret some data and retrieve some information from simple graphs and tables, both at home and at work. That is how we all end up speaking the mathematics language at various levels of complexity. Unfortunately, there is still a stigma of difficulty attached to mathematics, and it should not be allowed. On a rather sad note, in this country alone, we have probably lost a number of future women scientists through the gender-based violence. It's alarming to say the least. As a Wonder Woman in science, if I had superhero powers, really, I would be available just in time, every time, everywhere, to save the next victim of gender-based violence on time. Now, the history behind the gender gap must not hinder us as women. We still have a lot to achieve in various fields of sciences. Over the years, we see more girls and more women pursuing higher degrees in mathematics and in sciences. We also see female leaders in academia, and that is promising. Now, to girls and all the young people, my advice is, look beyond the role models you see every day. There is a huge spectrum of role models and careers to explore and choose from. Select a position you want to strive towards and work hard to achieve it. Note that along the way, you might fail, but that doesn't necessarily mean that you will not reach your destination. I like to tell this story because my friend, Dr. Daphne Matebula, a lecturer at University of Venda, also liked to tell this story. Her story is, she failed mathematics in matric, but today she is a PhD holder in mathematics from the University of Venda and the very first South African to obtain a mathematics PhD from the University of Venda. So the bottom line is, as long as you work hard and remain consistent, eventually all the hard work pays off. Thank you, Kate.
Thank you very much, Dr. Mteto. What an inspirational story. And you've spoken a really poignant, true and very relevant message in your addressing of the gender-based violence scourge across our country. So thank you very much for even taking this opportunity and this platform given to you in acknowledgement of your achievements to address something so, so crucial and so, so important. Now, as I was listening to you, understanding your fluency in mathematics, I couldn't help but take my mind back to my matric exam. And I thought, this is my opportunity. I need to ask this exam or this question that I was faced with. It was a bonus question for a bonus mark in my matric exam. I struggled with it for about a half an hour, and I'm still sure I got it wrong. So you can help me out, right? The question was this: what is the square root of 6,350,000.1234? No, I'm joking. No, you don't need to.
If you see such a question in the exam, don't panic. Move on to the next question.
That's absolutely sage words of advice. I will definitely keep that in mind. I hope you all keep that in mind as well. Wow, Dr. Mtento, thank you so much. I would like to see your award and your gift, please. Lovely, lovely. And once again, a big thank you to Amazon Web Services for sponsoring the Kindle e-reader, as well as Umgeni Water for sponsoring a fitness tracker and USB laser pointer pen for each of our Wonder Women in Science. I'd like to just give you the opportunity to share some final thoughts with us, Dr. Mtento.
I'm really grateful for this recognition and hope that all our stories will inspire many more young women to pursue careers in science. Now to every girl child, don't forget that your dreams are valid. Thank you.
Absolutely, well said. Also, while listening to your theme song, I was wondering, have you done the Jerusalem challenge yet?
Go to the website, www.is.ukzn.ac.za, and see my moves.
Hey, well, on that note, you can switch off your audio and your video. And yes, let's talk about that. The moves that the University of KwaZulu-Natal brings around. Now, if you've been checking out UKZN's social media channels, you would have seen WWIS content every day this month. And I'm talking from the panelists introducing themselves to trying some TikTok dances, taking on challenges. WWIS has certainly proved that they have the moves. Take a look at this if you don't believe me.
I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. If you can't let this one slide.
Okay, quarantine moves, yes, quarantine. On the left, to the right. One, two, three, four, then five. Okay, nay, nay, that's right. Do the wako, jacko, now slide. One clap, two claps.
Jerusalem, itayalami. Bilondoloze.
All our Wonder Women in Science, not just brilliant in mind and intellect, but brilliant on the dance floor as well. Thank you very much for that wonderful entertainment to all of our WWIS candidates. And thank you once again for your inspirational stories. It's been an absolutely amazing time to just delve into each of your stories and perhaps to find a point of identity, a link where one can say, hey, I've seen that aspect of my life playing out, and perhaps it's playing out right now, and I can learn from what you have done in achieving your success to maybe attain my own greatness as well. So thank you very much for all of those stories. But now we're ready to see some science in action. So I'd like to ask all of our attendees right now to switch to gallery view, please. So everyone, please switch to gallery view. Now, Dr. Tanya Reinhardt is the coordinator of the Science and Technology Education Center, known as STEC at UZN, UKZN. And she'll be leading the learners from Ikusasalenja Secondary and Umkumbani Secondary in two exciting science demonstrations. And I'd like to hand over to Dr. Reinhardt right now. We are ready to see some spectacular science. I was not ready for that outfit change, Dr. Reinhardt.
Thank you so much, Kaneto. I thought I'm going to give myself a slight makeover here. So a little bit of a hairdo, you know, just to dress up for the occasion. I'm usually wearing like a Gucci lab coat. Unfortunately, I'm in Cape Town. My lab coat is in Durban, so I had to borrow my husband's apron. So that should do it for today. Right, and welcome everybody for a little bit of science. And I think Bongiwe summed it up quite nicely is, you know, learning from a textbook, this is not really what you want to do. You really want to do science. And I often get the answer question, what is the age group to do the science experiment? Guys, you're never too old to do science experiments. You see, look at me, I'm over 20 and I'm still doing science. And today I'm gonna show you two science experiments. And as you can see, I'm not standing in a fancy lab here. I'm standing right in the middle of my kitchen. So you don't have to have a fancy lab to do science. For my very first experiment, I actually need two volunteers, and I can spot two volunteers at UKZN Secondary School. Can we just chime in? Can I call Z and Vicky? Hello, everybody. Hi, how's it? How are you? Can I just have your names, please? What are you?
Kumete Samgelsiwe.
Okay. Nice to meet you.
Asipekele.
Absolutely nice to meet you. I'm Tanya, or Dr. T, if you want to call me that. Are you ready for the action?
Yes, we are.
Oh, super. Okay, so what you will need is a glass. Just a simple glass. Can you grab a glass? Super. And I see that you already have a dressing on. Can you just remove the dressing, please? So we just need the glass dressing. Sorry, not your dressing. That's perfect. Just the glass dressing. Okay, just the glass dressing and not your dressing. Okay. All right, guys, if you could just. Okay, just an ordinary glass without the stuff on top. Okay. So a naked glass, I would say. Okay, a naked glass. Yeah, can we get. Okay, super. All right. Okay, now just put the dressing to the side, the skirt to the side. Okay, and we're going to grab a jug of water. Okay, super. And we're going to pour some water into our glass. Okay, so you can imagine if I'm going to turn this glass upside down, what's going to happen?
Water will pour out.
The water will fall out. Okay, so yes. So what we're going to do now is, and this is something that everybody has at home. This is just a piece of plastic from a yogurt lid. And guys, if you prefer ice cream, just sell it. You need, you know, ice cream for your experiment, and you just cut out a lid. So that's a flat lid. So you're going to place it on like this. Now we're going to hold it steady. We're going to press firmly down and we're going to turn it like this. Can we do that? I know that's a bit tricky. Super. Okay, and now if we can have the poll, guys, because now comes the question, what is going to happen if we're going to move away the hand? So all those lazy buns down at the, you know, at the other ends, sitting there in front and having coffee and nice chow and so on, please quickly vote. All right. Send you out your vote. And so you made the prediction. And we can close the poll, I think, hopefully. And now, carefully, what you have to do now is, oh, I can see, oh, what is that? So, the water is going to come out. So, 44% thinks that the water is going to come out, and 56% thinks that the water is not going to come out. We will see. So, you made the prediction, and now what we're going to do is we carefully move our hand down. And surprise, surprise. On my side, and also on your sides, the water stays inside. And I think this deserves a big round of applause. Don't you think so? Guys, in the audience, be active. Yes, super. paper. Awesome. Question is, what are you going to do if you're going to move the hand away? Okay. As you can see, the water is going to come out. All right. Okay, so with the polls a little bit early, because now what we're going to do is we're going to put our dressing on. Okay. So please return the glass and without the lid. Okay. Guys, can you hear me? Just turn the glass back. Turn the glass back. Take the lid off. Okay. And now we're going to put our little costume on, you know, and this is a net. Okay, so this is a net, like an onion net, right? So we're going to place it over. We're going to place it over. And we're going to secure it with a rubber band. And we're going to make it that it's quite tight. And to be quite honest, I tried it out this morning and it didn't work. So I hope this is going to work. Here we go. Quite nicely. And here you can see, hopefully everybody can see, there is some pores in the net. Oh, don't worry. I know it's tricky. Yes, super. That looks fabulous. Okay, guys, if you're ready, we're going to pour in some water. Here we go. We're going to pour in some water and we're going to do exactly the same experiment. So we're going to place the lid on. We're going to place the lid on. Yes. We're going to place the lid on. Yeah. And of course we fill it with water. Yes. We're going to place the lid on. We're going to turn it upside down. And you have to push very hard. Turn it upside down. Super. So now what do you think, and now we can launch the poll, another poll again. What do you think will now gonna happen if I gonna remove my hand? Can I have the poll, please? If not, doesn't matter. You can always make your own prediction in your head, okay? And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna slowly slide the lid sideways, just like this. Slide the lid sideways. And just see what's happening. Okay, so the majority were thinking that actually the water will come out. And as you can see, the water is still inside in my glass, and I can see that it's also still inside your, yeah, almost there. You see, it requires a little bit of practice, and this is what science is all about. It's not only about things going right, it's also about things going wrong. But I think you've done an amazing job. So my water is still inside, okay? So you keep on practicing, okay, guys? You keep on practicing. And the reason is, why did it do it? Okay, so quickly, this basically, when we put the lid on, what happened was that the water slightly, the lid slightly sagged inside the glass. Okay, so it created a lower air pressure, and then lots of outside air pressure was basically pushing against it. Secondly, there is something that is called surface tension, and this is the property of water. And water is this amazing substance that acts, in fact, like a glue that keeps the lid in place. And also, when you look very carefully, you might be able to see it. You can see there's water clinging to the pores of the net, and that keeps the water inside. Thank you so much. Please give these guys another big round of applause. Thank you so much. Well done, guys. Well done. Awesome. And now I'm being tasked to do a chemistry experiment. And I'm not a chemist, so and I'm also like always a little bit, have problems with it. So I'm going to call in on another volunteers. And I know these guys are experts because I'm working with them. And they're sitting right there at the Umkhombane school. Guys, can I just have a big shout from your side? Bye-bye, Ikusasa Slenja. Hello, Umkhombane, guys. I'm so happy to see you. Okay. Can you hear me? Yes, super. Okay. Right, so my timekeeper tells me that I have 5 minutes left. I'm probably going to go over time. Okay, super. Right, and I can see that you're already dressed, so you've got a lab coat on, yes? You've got safety goggles on, yes? You've got safety gloves, and as you can see, I don't have anything on like this, so I'll need my, you know, safety shield, and oops, sorry, guys. And I decided to go for the full Monty, okay? For the full Monty, so that it's for the beginners, and also ladies, for the occasion, I got myself some special gloves, you know, with the pink fingertips. Just, I thought that you might like that. And also what we're gonna do now is we're gonna work with chemicals. And when you ever work with chemicals, you have to wear, you know, your safety protection. Very, very important. Again, you can try this at home, but please make sure that you wear glasses, that you wear gloves, and that you wear something like a lab coat, because the chemicals that we are going to work with are basically not really very friendly. So we're going to use hydrogen peroxide, which I've got here. And hydrogen peroxide is basically a very strong oxidizing agent. And that can cause, you know, marks on your clothing if it's going to get onto it, just like bleach. Right, so what we're going to do today is we're going to make elephant's toothpaste. And then I looked at the fine print and it says actually it's not elephant's toothpaste, so I won't be able to brush an elephant's teeth, but this is rather a chemical reaction that makes, and you will see what it makes. All right, so what we've got here is we've got hydrogen peroxide, and I'm going to fill my hydrogen peroxide into the bottle. Go. Right. And to give it a little bit of a color, and I decided yellow. Red is the color, of course. I'm going to add some food coloring into my hydrogen peroxide. There we go. And last time, as I said, I'm not really a good chemist, so I forgot a main ingredient, which is your dishwashing liquid. I can see that you put in your hydrogen peroxide. Super. Okay, and awesome. And you added the food coloring. Now we're going to add a squirt of dishwashing liquid. Here we go. Now, hydrogen peroxide is chemically something that's called H2O2. So it's, don't confuse it with water, which is H2O. So this one has an oxygen more. And it usually breaks down quite nicely over time into water and oxygen. Now what we want to do is now we want to speed up this process a little bit. And we speed up this process by using a catalyst. And our catalyst in this case is just simple yeast. And you've got probably got your yeast solution, okay? Your yeast solution with water. Here we go. All right. And I can see that. Have your yeast solution ready? And you know what I didn't do? I forgot to ask your names. What is your name? Sorry, guys, I can't hear you. Okay, doesn't matter. I know you guys anyway, because I'm gonna come to your school again, and then we're gonna do proper experiments again. Okay, so on the count of three, so you're going to get ready. You're going to get ready. You're going to get close. And just watch out. Before you're going to pour, you pour, you're going to step back. Not that it's going to happen much, but you know, you better safe than sorry. Okay, so on the count of three. Okay, you ready? One, two, and don't forget, you know, remember, don't forget. You have to be ready, okay? Don't get nervous, all right? It's all fine, it's all fine, it's all cool. Okay, guys, on a count of three. One, two, three. And here we go. And as you can see, it's not really like, ah. So what's coming up now is, in fact, nice little foam. And all this foam contains one thing, a gas called oxygen. And I just have to try this out. So apparently, if I'm going to put in a splinter, okay, so this is nicely, this is, please don't try this at home, guys. We're going to put it out. And it doesn't work. So again, it shows science experiments not always work, but it doesn't matter. It was worth a try. And I love the elephant toothpaste. So guys, please, thank you so much for helping me out with this. And please, audience, put together your hands and give them a big round of applause. And for those who don't know what to do, because it's too long ago, you just, you know, bash your hands together. And I think my time is long up, so I'll hand back to Katlego. Thank you so much.
Dr. T, you are the best. You make science so much fun. I really, really enjoyed those experiments, and especially the headdress that you're wearing. Very entertaining. Thank you very much.
I have to say, I usually wear a different color, but I thought I'm going to go colorful this time. So yes, pleasure.
Well, to everyone watching, I hope that you certainly enjoyed those experiments presented by the learners from the two schools and, of course, Dr. Tanya Reinhardt as well. But right now, it is time for us to do something very cool. But before we do that, I need to also let you know that this entire webinar is being recorded and will be made available on the www.iis.ukzn.co.za website. Okay, so if you missed anything, you can go back to the website and watch the entire thing, and especially hear all the speakers if you didn't get the chance to hear all of their stories. But yes, it is time for the lucky draw, where you can stand a chance to win amazing prizes. And just by logging into this webinar, you are eligible for a prize. So this is how we're going to do it. We're going to do it via lucky draw. Okay, so first up, we're going to cross over to Mzee, who is at the Ikusasale just secondary, to do the first draw. Of course, we've had great prizes that have been donated by our corporate partners. Thank you very, very much to them. And these prizes are now about to be awarded. So Mzee, over to you.
Yes, I got Katlego. Thank you. Guys, my name is Mzee. So now it's time for the lucky draws. So what I'll do, I will pick up a name here and call it, and you'll come decide to take your gift and then take a picture, right? Okay, so our first draw is a set of wireless earbuds sponsored by Elsevier. So now it's time to win. Let's check who the winner is. The winner is Ngubane Mphumeleli. Thank you, Ngubane Mphumeleli. You can sit down. Our next draw, we have a book. We have a book, pen, and a USB that is sponsored by Umgeni Waters. Let us check again who the lucky winner is. The lucky winner is Zulu Nokwanda. Thank you, Nokwanda. Our last gift, we have a laptop. We have a laptop bag and the wireless charging mat that is sponsored by Tucana Solutions. So let's check who the lucky winner is. And the lucky winner is Kumete Samkelisi. Thank you. If you did not win today, relax. Next time it will be you. Back to you, Katlego. Thank you.
Yo, Prof. Z, thanks very much for keeping the energy and the flow alive over there. And also, once again, thanks so much to all of our corporate partners that have sponsored these wonderful prizes to be won in today's special occasion. All right, we're going to cross over right now to Sam, who's at Umkhumbani Secondary for our next draw. Sam, over to you.
Thanks, Katlego. Hi, I'm Sam, and we're about to start our lucky draw. So the first prize is wireless earbuds sponsored by Elsevier. And the winner is Manyanga Angel. Not sure. Oh, shame. The winner is Shabalala Spumelele. Not sure. People are absent, guys. See, she's busies. Please stand there. Grab this. Stay. No, the first time. Ethan, Jason, let's take a picture. Ethan? 1 meter distance. Show the logo, please. Turn it around. Yeah, there we go. All right, thank you. The next prize is a book, pen, and USB sets from Umgeni. I hope this person is here. Mkize Ngobile. Umgeni. Take a picture. And the last prize, it's a laptop bag, wireless charging mat, and headsets sponsored by Tucana. This is your last chance, guys. Kumalo, always. Please grab your gift. Thank you. Back to you, Katlego.
Thanks so much, Samantha, and congratulations to our winners there at Umkhumbani Secondary, as we now cross over to Mrs. Sanpat, who is at Eden College for the next lucky draw. Over to you, Mrs. Sanpat.
Thank you, Katlego. Hi, everyone. I'm Mrs. Sanpat, and we're ready to do our lucky draw with our girls from Eden. So I'm going to pick a name out of my jar. And the winner is... And Jasmine is receiving a pair of headphones that we have been sponsored by UKZN's IPS division. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, UKZN, and I'm handing you back over to...
Thanks so much, Mrs. Sanpat, there at Eden College. And congratulations to all of our winners so far as we continue our lucky draw. And we're going to be doing this part now as a series of lucky draws for the other schools that are also joining us via webinar. Now, we've taken a register at each of the schools and assigned each of the learners a number. So we will draw a number to then determine who our winner is. So we're starting off at Noma Bimbela High School. And I'm going to ask that Hlonipile please join us via video as well as audio. And then Lena, you're going to be joining us via audio only to join us and to help us give up or give out these prizes. All right. So Hlonipile, you can hear me. And Lena, you can hear me as well. Excellent. All right. So here's how it is going to work. The first one for Noma Bimbela High School, we are drawing for 3 headphones that have been donated by UKZN's ICS division. So Hlonipile, you have the duty of giving me 3 numbers between 1 and 32. Here we go.
1, 3 and 31.
1, 3 and 31. I got that right. 1, 3 and 31. All right, Lena, you can tell us who our winners are.
Number 1 is Neliswe Buthelezi. Number 3 is Bonile Lamini.
And number 31 is Tandikile Nene.
Fantastic. Congratulations to our winners there from Nomavimbela High School. All right. As we now move on to Usetubeni Youth School. And for this one, I'm going to ask Bongiwe to please join me via video and audio. Lena, you are still there with us via audio. And when I have Bongiwe, who is now tuning in, and there she is in a few seconds, I'm going to ask that Bongiwe please give us three numbers. Okay. Dr. Mshengu is going to give us three numbers between 1 and 26. Let's hear it.
9, 18, and 24.
Lena, who are our winners?
Okay, number 9 is Sifibe Lutuli. Number 18 is Bonile Ndlovu. And number 24 is Tuso Teleyane.
Wonderful. Congratulations to our winners from Usetubeni Youth School. Thanks very much, Bongiwe, for helping us out over there. Now, I'd like to ask Loreka to please join us via camera and audio for our next draw. There she is. Wonderful stuff. We are drawing here for three headphones donated by UKZN's ICS division. So, Loreka, your duty in this lucky draw is to give us three numbers between 1 and 34. All right, Loreka, I'm not sure if you can hear me. Well, I think you can hear me. I certainly can't hear you yet, which means everyone else can't hear you. So maybe if you just la, 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 la. I'm not sure if that'll help, but you try again. So from 1 to 34, what are the numbers? So that's 7. All right, you're going to have to sign this one for us. I got the first number as 7, then 24. Or the 14. 7, 14, and 21. Okay, yes, I got it. 7, 14, and 21. Lena, who are our winners there?
Okay, 7 is Alexandria Durga. 14 is Neo Jama. And the last one, sorry, what's the last one?
21.
21 is Ryan Mudley.
Fantastic. Congratulations to the winners over there. Now, we are going to go into the last lot of lucky draws for all of you viewers online. So do come closer to the screen and do listen up very carefully for your name. Now, we've made a list of all of the attendees for this webinar and assigned each person a number. So we will then draw numbers to determine the winner. And all the prizes will then be posted to the winners as we have collected your details as well upon your registration. So don't worry, you'll get those prizes. All right, the first one is the Umgeni water draw. And I'm gonna ask Joy to please join via camera and audio. And then Christine will be joining me via audio right now. There we go, fantastic. So we are drawing for 6 book, pen, and USB sets courtesy of Umgeni Water. Thank you very much to them. So Joy, first up, I'm gonna ask you to give me three numbers from 1 to 300.
25, 150, 280.
25, 150, 280. Christine, who are our winners?
Thank you, Joy. The first winner is Nozipo Hadebe. That's our number 25. Congratulations, Nozipo. The second winner of this prize is Kemi Adewale. Well done, Kemi. And the last winner of this one is Nosikle Kulu.
All right, fantastic. Thanks very much, Christine. Joy, you are still up now. And I'm going to make this one a bit more challenging for you, okay? So you got to concentrate on this one. I need three numbers from 300 to 600, please.
300, 450, 570.
300, 450, 570. Those are the numbers. Christine, who are our winners?
So the first winner is Penyo Desiree. Well done, Penyo. The second winner that we have is Shalene Garage. Well done, Shalene. And the last winner for this one is Mbali Dlamini.
Congratulations to our winners. Thank you very much, Joy. A pleasure to see you once again. As we now move on to our next draw, which is the Tucana draw. And I'm going to ask that Suna please join us for this one. We still have Christine on audio who will be helping us to determine who our winner is. And in this particular one, we are drawing for a bundle, which includes a laptop bag, wireless charging mat, and external speakers donated by Tucana Solutions. Thank you very, very much to them. All right, so Suna, here's how it's going to work. You're going to give me a number, a single number from 1 to 600.
502.
502. That's as random a number as I've ever heard. Okay, Christine, who are the winner? Who's the winner?
Thanks, Suna. That would be Kulagani Kumaro.
Fantastic. Congratulations to you, Kulagani. And then our final draw for today from Elspeth. Suna, you're going to be helping us as well. And we are drawing for 3 external hard drives donated by Elspeth. Now, Suna, you're going to have to give me 3 numbers from 100 to 300, please.
All right. 125, 204. And let's make it a 280.
125, 204, 280.
And 280.
All right, Christine, you heard that. Who are our winners?
Yes. Amahle Ngobo is our first winner for that one. Well done, Amahle. And the second winner is Nontokozo Mbukazi. Well done, Nontokozo. And our last winner for that one is Elizabeth Letswalo.
Congratulations to our winners once again. And now finally, we are drawing for 3 wireless earbuds donated by Elsfield. What an incredible prize indeed. Thank you very much to Elsfield there. So Suna, you need to give us 3 numbers from 300 to 600, please. Suna?
320, 404, and 460.
320, 404, and 460. All right, Christine, you heard it.
Yes. So the first winner is Pebo and Kumalo. Well done. Then the second winner of that hard drive. Just give me a second.
Not too worried.
Is Letumbulelo Mbata. Well done. And then our last winner for this one is Nombuso Zondo.
Wonderful stuff. Thank you very, very much to you, Christine, and to all of our panelists who helped us to determine the winners of this lucky draw. And to all of the winners, congratulations. The crowd is going wild for you, believe me. They're all going wild right now. Thank you to the entire organization and the initiative for getting myself involved along with my team as well. I'd like to thank you, our attendees, for being part of this very, very special morning. And as we close things off, I'd like you all to please now switch to gallery view so we can say goodbye to all of our panelists. And our panelists, please turn on your video and your audio as well. We want to say a last little goodbye. Bye, Lorica. Bye, Thonipile. Bye, Joy. Bye, Suna. Bye, Tanya. Bye, Bongiwe. Just got to get it in for everyone in there. Thank you very much for sharing your incredible stories and inspiring us today. It has been truly, truly wonderful. And I'd like to also take a moment to say goodbye to everyone at the schools, of course, at Ikusasalentsha Secondary as well as Umkhumbane Secondary. Let's get you guys to give us a wave and a goodbye. There we go. Certainly can see the enthusiasm there. And I hope that you guys have been truly inspired. And then, of course, ladies and gentlemen, and everyone in attendance to this webinar, on behalf of the University of KwaZulu-Natal, we'd certainly like to say thank you very much to all of you who attended for joining us this morning. And we hope that you have discovered your own greatness, that you are inspired to cultivate it every single day. And the last goodbye from myself, Katlego Maboe, just saying a big thank you once again for getting me involved in this very, very special, very, very unique and crucially important project. And especially to all the young people that have been tuned in that are watching now, I'd like to leave you with these words. And these are the words of the great Ntate Nelson Mandela, who said this. And think about this as you think about pursuing your future careers, especially in the world of science and how you've heard how it can change the lives of people every single day. And Ntate Nelson Mandela once said that overcoming poverty is not an act, it's not a task of charity. It is an act of justice. Like slavery and apartheid, poverty is not natural. It is man-made, and it can be overcome and eradicated by the actions of human beings. Sometimes it falls on a generation to be great. You can be that generation. Let your greatness blossom. Take those words with you as you proceed on into your life and make this world a better place through your individual contributions from your heart. Thank you very, very much. All right. On that note, please, everybody, switch to speaker view because we have something very special to conclude this event. And that is another stunning performance from the spectacular Miss Lira. From myself, Katlego Maboe, goodbye and God bless you.
Well, thank you so much for joining us for such an inspiring morning, as we heard from the UKZN's Wonder Women in Science. I trust that every student watching soaked up every drop of knowledge, information, inspiration that was shared this morning. And I personally just want to leave you with these words.
Something inside so strong. Oh, I know that I can make it. But you're doing me wrong, so wrong. You thought that my pride was gone. But oh no, something inside so strong. Oh, something inside so strong. The more you refuse to hear my voice, the louder I will sing. Yeah. You hide behind the walls of Jericho, your lies will come tumbling down. Whoa.
Thank you so much once again for tuning in. God bless you all.